In my last video, I have explained you how hub, switch and router works in a network and what is the differences between them. If you are interested, I will provide you the link of that video in the description section below. In this video, you are going to learn how bridge works in a network. And this is going to be a completely practical video, so I will highly recommend you to watch this video till the end. Hello friends, this is Abhishek here and welcome back to my channel Technical Tech. Let's the tech begin.
Visit our website www.learnavi.com or download our Android application Networking Plus to practice networking quiz, interview questions and many more. For more information, check the link in the description section below.
First of all, let's understand what is bridge. Bridge is a networking device that works in a data link layer of OSI model. It is used to divide a network traffic into two different segments. Okay, bridge also have the capability to store MAC addresses. Now, how bridge works in a network? Let's find out with live example.
As you can see, here I have one network where I have connected two hub and six PC. All of these devices are connected to each other and also able to communicate with each other. But this time, we have not yet connected bridge. First of all, let me show you what will happen if there is no bridge in a network. See, if I try to send a data from PC number 1 to this PC number 2, what is going to happen? Let's find out. Click on next. Hub is going to receive the data. Hence, hub is a broadcast device and it do not have any capability to store MAC address. And this hub don't know in this entire network who is the second PC, who is 10.0.0.2. For this reason, it is going to broadcast the data to all the devices connected to it. Okay. Hence, PC number 2 is the PC contain 10.0.0.2 IP address. For this reason, it has accepted the data. Okay. But this PC is not 10.0.0.2. For this reason, it has rejected the data and data has been also sent to the next hub. Okay. Again, this hub don't know who is 10.0.0.2. For this reason, again, it is also going to broadcast the data to all the devices connected to it. Like this, it is keep broadcasting the data all the time. Okay, it do not store any MAC address and many time you send data, all the time it is going to broadcast the data to all the devices connected to it. And it simply creates lots of traffic. Let me show you one more example. If I try to send a data from PC number 1 to this PC number 4, what will happen? Let me show you. Click on next. This hub don't know who is PC number 4. So again, it is going to broadcast the data to all the devices connected to it. Got it? See, again, this hub is also going to broadcast the data to all the devices connected to it. So simply, it is creating lots of traffic and it consumes lots of bandwidth. So from overcoming this problem, we use a centralized device called bridge. This time we are going to add a bridge in the center and let's connect both the hubs together. Done. Now let's send data from PC number 1 to this PC number 2 and let's see what is going to happen. Let's click on next. Hub has received the data and it is going to broadcast the data to all the devices connected to it. Hence, bridge has the capability to store MAC addresses, right? So this bridge knows very well the PC number 2 is not available in this segment. For this reason, it has blocked the data here itself. It is not going to send this data in this second segment. And like this, it is saving the network traffic. Got it? Let me delete this from here. Again, if you send the data from PC number 1 to this PC number 3, what is going to happen? Let's find out. Let's click on next. Okay. PC number 3 is available on first segment. So if I click on next. See, again, bridge has blocked the data here itself. It is not sending this traffic to the second segment. And like this, it is consuming less bandwidth and it is also try to help you in reducing the network traffic. Got it? Let me show you one last example. If I send the data from PC number 1 to this PC number 4, what is going to happen? Let's find out. Click on next. Hub is going to receive the data. Bridge has received the data. So this time, this bridge knows very well that PC number 4 is available on the second segment. That's why it has accepted the data and it is going to forward the data to the next hub. Click on next. And this hub is again going to broadcast the data to all the devices connected to it. Got it? So like this, it is dividing a network traffic into two different segments so that it can reduce the traffic and also it can consume less bandwidth. So this is the main function and main work of bridge, and this is how a networking device bridge works in a network.
I hope the concept of bridge is clear. Here it's time for the surprise test. The question is, tell me, bridge works under which layer of OSI model? Let me know this answer in the comment section below and let's see whether you have understand the concept of bridge or not. Hope you have enjoyed watching this video, then please hit the like button. If you are watching this video for the first time on my channel, do subscribe to my channel right now and also hit the bell icon, and don't forget to download our Android application Networking Plus. Thanks for watching.